Good evening, everyone, and a warm welcome to the beautiful audience gathered here. Our chief guest has arrived. Reverend fathers, sisters, ladies and gentlemen, I request you to rise and put your hands together to welcome the guests. I request the dignitaries to kindly move on to the dais.
Today is our big day, the most anxiously awaited day. To think of how far flung we have come and how afar we have to go. Good evening, one and all present here.
Our well-acclaimed guest of honor, honored management, all treasured invitees, reverend fathers and sisters, members of both teaching and non-teaching community, and of course our starling students. How lovely and pleasant is this day, and so does the ambience and aura surrounding it. Today is a special and memorable occasion that we will remember in the year ahead. It is the time to chill, to cheer, to shine, to inspire, and to be inspired.
It is honored to be surrounded by so many special people and to be blessed in the fellowship of this occasion. May the excitement of today enthuse you. May its enchantment surround you, and may the fellowship that we share create happy memories and smiling magical moments. May the magical moments be many and memorable. Yes, we are all mustered here this evening as a family to revel addition of another milestone of our accomplishment in the history of St. Teresa's Convent Girls Higher Secondary School, Nayatingra. I, Anvia,
and I, Esna,
with full of engaging elation and soulful musical rendition, welcome you all to this vista of floral, flow of musical feelings, and glow of gorgeous dealings on behalf of the entire Theresian family. To begin with, we shall seek for the countless and choicest blessings of our Creator through a prayer song by our school choir.
Bringing down God's blessings on all of us. May I invite Miss Ananda and Miss Anushra to welcome the gathering.
Good evening, one and all. I am Ananda LB, the head girl of the school.
And I am Anushra S. Kumar, the captain of Sapphire House.
Wow, what a gathering we have here tonight. We have got dignitaries, organizational members, and all brought together for one cause. Here is an appreciative welcome to you all. Luckily, the weather is on our side today. First and foremost, I would like to seek the presence of our Lord Almighty, the Creator of the world. From the bottom of my heart, I humbly and gratefully welcome our Lord Almighty to bless us, be with us, and grant us great success on this auspicious day. The fragrance of flowers spread only in the direction of the wind, but the goodness of a person spreads in all directions. Amidst us, we have such an inspiring personality, Reverend Sister Mary Elma, the Provincial Superior of Southern Province. She is a person of multi-personality who had her higher studies in Rome and served in Africa for 5 years. She has played various roles in her career as a principal, as a superior general, as a junior mistress of Pune Novitiate, as a provincial superior for 3 years. In fact, she was selected as a provincial superior twice. She is excellent in administration and a very loving, down-to-earth person who had battled against all odds and reached the pinnacle of success. She is highly passionate about uplifting the downtrodden and infused hope among people. Undoubtedly, she is a living proof of an exemplar of humanity. Her service to the society is noteworthy. We are very fortunate to have her with us this evening as a chief guest. We extend an affable welcome to you, dear sister.
I'm very proud to take this opportunity to welcome the humble and hardworking personality, Reverend Sister Mary Grace, the manager of our school. She is blessed with numerous capacities. She is excellent in humanity and a dedicated person with vibrant spirituality. And also, she is the one who leads us in the right way of academic and also in the right way of spirituality. We are really blessed to have you as our manager. We bid a very delightful welcome to you, dear sister.
Nothing great will be achieved without great men. And men are only great if they are determined to do so. To our honor, we have Reverend Father Monsignor Alphonse Ligori, the parish priest of Immaculate Conception Cathedral, Neyatinkara. He is an episcopal vicar of Neyatinkara. Also, the manager of Christo Jodi Senior Secondary CBSE School. He is always steady with his hands on the deep faith, courage of convictions, pastoral concern, and unwavering commitment to his mission and determined efforts to take everyone along in realization of God's plan. We welcome you, dear Father, and wish you a splendid time with us.
One tree can start a forest. One word can frame a goal. One candle can wipe out darkness. A true leader has a confidence to stand alone, the courage to make tough decisions, and the compassion to listen to the need of others is an art. Our beloved principal, Reverend Sister Flori Padua, does not set out to be a leader, but becomes a special one by the equality of her action and integrity of her intent. The quote above said is very much filling to our lovable Reverend Sister Flori Padua, our principal. You are our leader. You show motherly love and give fatherly confidence. We are really blessed to have a principal like you. With a thankful heart, we welcome you, dear sister.
The more you take responsibility of your past and present, the more you are able to create the future you seek. It is my turn to extend a gracious and inclusive welcome to our lovable sister Sophie Joseph, the vice principal of our institution. It is your sense of commitment which creates an apt platform for us to grow both mentally and spiritually. On this great evening, with merging of minds, we welcome you, dear sister. Also, we have our respected sister Larina, in charge of high secondary, Sister Mary Bergmans, in charge of LP section, and Sister Mary VT with us. We are really happy to have you, sisters. Also, we bid a very warm welcome to you, dear sisters.
A sincere and warm welcome from the depth of our heart, our PTA President, Mr. Gopakumar, and our Vice President, Reverend Mohan Raj, who are the personalities much concerned about the goodwill of our institution. Their cooperation is a point to be highlighted. They are always the backbone of our institution. We welcome you, dear sirs.
The teacher who indeed wise doesn't bid you to enter the house of his wisdom, but rather leads you to the threshold of your mind. We take this opportunity to honor and welcome our dear teachers who chisel and shape our lives and make us to be a good citizen of this society. Your hard work brings out the best in us. We humbly welcome our lovable Mrs. Hazel Leo, the teachers' representative of our school. She is with us to represent the teachers of our school, also to motivate us. We welcome you, dear teachers, with our grateful heart. Also, we would like to welcome our non-teaching staff who work hand in hand with us, make us feel relieved, moved a mile forward for this great occasion. We welcome all our dear non-teaching staff to this great event. To the world, you may be the person, but to the one, you may be the world. With immense pleasure, we welcome our dear parents. We do cherish your partnership and collaboration in all our endeavors. Your esteemed presence today amidst us makes us feel proud. We welcome, dear parents.
Children are the world's most valuable resource and its best hope for future. Yes, dear friends, you are the gifts of God, precious pearls of the society, and building blocks of the strong nation. The institution and its manifold activities revolves around you. You become the center of everything. Your cuteness, frankness, innocence, discipline, and uniqueness decree this great institution. Dear friends, you have proven that this annual day is not happening by luck. It's your hard work and perseverance that make this occasion vibrant, successful, and memorable one. With a joyful heart, we welcome Miss Ananda, head girl of our school, for this occasion. She represents the whole school. We welcome you, dear students.
All birds find shelter during rain, but eagle avoids rain by flying above the cloud. Problems are common, but attitude makes the difference, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Thanks of the level of immense propensity to all the luminaries on the stage once again, and also to all the parents, guardians, guests, and the tons of untiring efforts of endless number of students and teachers. Once again, we welcome you all. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you, Ananda and Anushwara. We shall now have our traditional auspicious lamp lighting ceremony as a tribute to Almighty God. Light is a symbol of brightness and prosperity, as sunlight expels the darkness of night. Similarly, blessings bring in our life prosperity and happiness. Lord Jesus, we pray for your blessings with all humility. Give us wisdom and strength to celebrate this day.
I invite our chief guest, Reverend Sister Mary Elma, Reverend Sister Mary Grace, our manager, Reverend Sister Flori Padua, our principal, Reverend Sister Sophie Joseph, Vice Principal, Reverend Monsignor Alphonse Ligori, the Parish Priest of Immaculate Conception Cathedral, Niyatingara, Mr. Gobakumar, PTA President, Reverend Mohan Raj, PTA Vice President, Mrs. Hazel Leo, Teacher Representative, Miss Ananda, to kindle the lamp.
We invite Reverend Sister Larina, Reverend Sister Mary VT, and Reverend Sister Mary Bergman to kindle the lamp.
Human beings live in harmony with nature. May the darkness of ignorance be swept away by the dawn of self-realization.
Find.
Knock and it will be open to you. The tiny tots are here, asking, seeking, and knocking through a prayer dance.
May the Lord
dance. Give them a big round of applause.
Let's welcome the sweetest voices of St. Teresa's with a beautiful song.
The Theresian Nightingales are ready to sit out with a song to welcome everyone.
Thank you.
much, Theresian Nightingales, for your graceful song.
Dance is the most beautiful form of expression of human feelings. Dancers are the messengers of God. Today, we are about to witness some great talents. So let's gear up for a beautiful start of the show with a welcome dance.
Cultural program we begin with?
Shall we start with unity in diversity?
Okay, the fifth standard students are before us with a classical dance, Unity in Diversity, that which proclaims the unity in diversity.
Well everyone, I remember the famous quote of the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Our ability to reach unity in diversity will be the beauty and the test of our civilization.
We may all have the different religions, language, food, culture, differently colored skin, but we all belong to one human race. Unity is not uniformly, unity in diversity is India's strength. Enjoy the dance of our fifth standard students, Unity in Diversity.
Dum dum da na 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 dum dum agapa. Dum dum da na na de na 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 dum dum magasa. Da gir da dum da 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 di ra na 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 na. Da da gir da dum da gir da dum da gir da dum 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 da na 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 de na 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 dum. Da na di ra na gama gama magapa pa magasa ni sa. Da na di ra na gama gama magapa pa magasa ni sa. Sanya Dira Na Gama Gama Magama Baba Gazani Sa. Come on now, follow my lead. Come on now, follow my lead. Gama Baba Gama Gama Baba Gama Sa. Gama Baba Gama Gama Baba Gama Sa. Wampani Pagama Gama Baba Gama Sa. Sa 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 Gama Basa Gama. I'm in love with your body.
Tanda Nyanum Baram Trishur Puram Kana.
What a pious and graceful start of the show. This performance truly signified unity in diversity.
Ainsley,
thank you, dears.
Ainsley, now can we keep everyone smiling at least for some time?
Why do you say so?
Because our first standards are here with a smile dance.
Let's enjoy the smile dance.
Playing ukulele, and when I went to the girl, come on and teach me to sing. way. She left and whispered to me, yes, come tonight to the bay. The lovely beach in the sky, the moon of Kauai, around Calypso Sarong, we'll all be singing the song. Aga do, 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 push pineapple, shake the tree. Aga do, 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 push pineapple, grind coffee. To the left, to the right, jump up and down until the knees. Come and dance every night, sing the hula melody. Aga do, 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 push pineapple, shake the tree. Aga do, 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 push pineapple, grind coffee. To the left, to the right, jump up and down until the knees.
Performance was thunderstorming and mind-blowing. Thank you, dears.
Next, we have an improvised style of presentation, fusion dance.
Indeed, it's marvelous to watch that our 6th standard students rocking on the floor with a magnificent performance. Cinematic fusion dance.
Let's move forward to a different dance. Arsha, see the title of the dance?
Oh, that means now the dancers have also become eco-friendly.
Let this dance be an awareness campaign. Let's say no to all plastic materials that we permanently spoil our Mother Earth, thereby human beings. Let's watch an outstanding performance of our second standard students, Beat Plastic Dance.
Tick 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 tick. Kasam ye khaye re. Tick 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 tick. Plastic tick ma paaye re. Tick 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 tick. Kasam ye khaye re. Tick 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 tick. Plastic tick ma paaye re.
अगर सुन लो जिस्म लेना हम तो बम ये फट जाएगा के बहती सी है नदियां का ये पानी रुक जाएगा
अगर सुन लो जिस्म लेना हम तो बम ये फट जाएगा के बहती सी है नदियां का ये पानी रुक जाएगा
के दर्द और है धरती का ये दम भी घुट जाएगा के कुदरत की हनस नस में जहर ये बस जाएगा
प्लास्टिक के हम सब मोहताज हैं कैसा ये समाज है
कल ना हो हाथों में आज है
मौका ये अपना गवाए रे
Bye bye re
tick 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 tick
kasam ye khaye re
tick 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 tick
plastic tick na paaye re
tick 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 kasam ye khaye re tick 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 plastic tick na paaye re
a thought provoking performance.
So, everybody, we hope all of us will beat plastic hereafter. Abisha, I bet we all will be forced to clap for the next program.
Yes, we will. Everybody hold your hearts to see this astounding safari dance by the Standard 9 girls.
First time we ever meet, you make the time feel slow, so just like slow rivers flow, so I see the fire in your eyes, it makes me feel, it takes me high, so bring me on the dance floor.
We dance so
come on boy, move that body. Cause tonight I'm naughty, naughty. Dance with me like it's my party. We go wild, we're in safari. Come on boy, move that body. Cause tonight I'm naughty, naughty. Dance with me like it's my party. We go wild, we're in safari. Ay, ay, ay.
It was indeed crazy.
Gauri, we have now a fascinating dance on stage, a stunning and eye-catching dance performance of our third standard students.
By watching this dance, you can understand how fairly these pairs put their steps together.
Watch and enjoy. Thank you, friends. You entertained us all very well. The next program is a Malayalam skit. Malayala Kareile, Oro Malayalide, Nenjidipinum, Prathanakim Idayakia, Pralaya Durandatile, Urunat Varta, Ida Ningal Kumunil, Drishya Vishkaratilude.
Thank you. ദൈവത്തിന്റെ സ്വന്തം നാടായ നമ്മുടെ കേരളത്തിലെ ഒരു കൊച്ചു വാർത്തയിലേക്ക് നമുക്കും കാതോർക്കാം. നീല കളറുള്ള സൈക്കിൾ.
വാണി, എനിക്ക് മാത്സിൽ ഇന്ന് പഠിപ്പിച്ച പോർഷൻ കുറച്ച് സംശയമുണ്ട്, അതൊന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു തരണേ. പിന്നെ അതൊക്കെ പോട്ടെ, ഈ പ്രളയ ദുരിതാശ്വാസ നിധിയിലേക്ക് സംഭാവനയായി എന്താ കൊടുത്തത്?
ഞാനൊരു പാക്കറ്റ് അരിയും 5 സോപ്പും കൊടുത്തു.
ഞാൻ 500 രൂപയാ കൊടുത്തത്.
ഇന്നലെ ടിവിയിൽ ന്യൂസ് കണ്ടപ്പോൾ സങ്കടം വന്നു അരുണിമ. പ്രകൃതി ഇത്രയും ക്രൂരയായി തീരുമോ?
വാണി, ആദ്യമൂത്ത മനുഷ്യർ തന്നെയാണ് പ്രകൃതിയെ കാർന്നു തിന്ന് ഇത്രയും ക്രൂരയാക്കി മാറ്റിയത്.
അത് ശരി തന്നെ. പക്ഷേ നമ്മളെ പോലെയുള്ള കുട്ടികളാ പലരും ഒന്ന് സുരക്ഷിതമായി കിടന്നുറങ്ങാൻ വീട് പോലും ഇല്ലാത്ത അവസ്ഥയാ അവർക്ക്.
ആ
അരുണിമ അറിഞ്ഞോ ഇന്ന് പത്രത്തിൽ വന്ന വാർത്ത?
ഇല്ല വാണി, ഞാനും നെണീറ്റ പോലെ ലേറ്റായി പോയി. എന്ത് വാർത്തയാ വാണി, ഒന്ന് വേഗം പറ.
എന്റെ റബ്ബേ, എപ്പോ തുടങ്ങിയ പണിയാ? ഇന്നെങ്കിലും സമയത്ത് ബംഗ്ലാവിൽ എത്താൻ പറ്റുമോ പടച്ചോനെ? ഇന്നലെയും ബൈക്ക് കേട്ടതാ, അവിടെയും കാണും ഒരു കൂട്ടം പാത്രവും തുണിയും കഴുകാന്.
ഉമ്മാ,
ആ നീ എത്തിയോ എന്റെ ആരിഫേ?
ഉമ്മാ ഇത് കണ്ടാ, ഇന്ന് പത്രം പിച്ചു കിട്ടിയ കായന് ഞമ്മള് വാങ്ങിയതാ.
ഇടേ ഇബിലീസേ, വാടക കൊടുത്തിട്ടില്ല, മമ്മദിന്റെ പലിശയും കൊടുത്തിട്ടില്ല. ഞമ്മള് അയല് വീടുകളിൽ പോയി പാത്രം കഴുകി കിട്ടണ കായ് കൊണ്ട് എന്താകാനാടാ? നീ പത്രം വിറ്റ് കിട്ടണ കായ് കൊണ്ട് വാടകയെങ്കിലും കൊടുക്കാന്നാ കരുതിയേ, അതും ഇപ്പൊ പോയി കിട്ടിയില്ലോ എന്റെ പടച്ചോനെ.
എന്റെ ഉമ്മ, നിങ്ങള് കിടന്ന് കരയാണ്ടിരിക്കി, ഇത് കായ് ശേഖരിക്കാനുള്ള കുടുക്കയാ. നാളെ മുതല് പത്രം വിറ്റ് കിട്ടുന്ന കായ് ഞാൻ ഇതിലിട്ട് വെക്കും, നിങ്ങള് ബേജാറാവണ്ടാന്ന്.
കണ്ട കണ്ട, നാല് കായ് കണ്ടപ്പോ ചെക്കന്റെ സ്വഭാവം മാറണ കണ്ട.
ഇല്ലുമ്മ, എന്റെ സ്വഭാവം മാറണതല്ല, ഇപ്പോ മുതലാളി ഞമ്മക്ക് 100 വീട്ടിലിടാനുള്ള പത്രാണ് തരണത്.
അതിനിപ്പോ എന്താ, നിങ്ങക്ക് പോരാന്നുണ്ടോ എന്റെ ആരിഫേ?
ഞമ്മടെ കൂടെ പത്രടാൻ വരുന്ന ഹരിച്ചേട്ടന് ഒരു സൈക്കിൾ ഉണ്ടുമ്മ, അതുകൊണ്ട് മുതലാളി പെരുത്ത് പത്രവും കൊടുക്കും, അങ്ങനെ കൂടുതൽ കായും കിട്ടും. ഞമ്മക്കും വാങ്ങണമ്മ ഒരു നീല സൈക്കിള്.
അതിപ്പോ എന്താ ഒരു നീല കളറ്?
ഞമ്മടെ ടീച്ചർ പറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നത് നീല പ്രതീക്ഷയുടെ നിറാണെന്നാ. അത് കടലിന്റെയും ആകാശത്തിന്റെയും നിറല്ലേ ഉമ്മ?
അതിപ്പം പെരുത്ത് കായാവൂലേ എന്റെ ആരിഫേ?
അതിനല്ലേ ഉമ്മായി കുടുക്ക, ഇതില് ഞമ്മള് ദിവസവും കായിട്ട് ഇത് നിറയുമ്പം ഒരു സൈക്കിള് വാങ്ങും, പിന്നെയും നിറയുമ്പം ഞമ്മക്ക് സ്വന്തമായിട്ട് ഒരു വീട് വെക്കണമ്മ.
ആ എന്റെ മോനിപ്പോ സ്കൂളിൽ പോവാൻ നോക്ക്. എന്റെ റബ്ബേ, ചെക്കന്റെ ഓരോ മോഹങ്ങള് പടച്ചോനെ, എന്റെ കുഞ്ഞിനെ കാത്തോണെ.
ആരുമില്ലേ ഇവിടെ? ഉമ്മാ ഇതാ വാസുമാമൻ.
വാസുവേട്ടാ, അടുത്ത ആഴ്ച നമ്മള് വാടക അങ്ങോട്ട് കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് തരാം.
നീ അത്രയും കഷ്ടപ്പെടണ്ട, ഇപ്പോ തന്നേച്ചാ മതി.
എന്റെ റബേ, എന്റെ കയ്യിലിപ്പോ കായില്ലല്ലോ.
ആ ചെറുക്കൻ കുടുക്കയില് കാശിടുന്നത് കണ്ടല്ലോ, അതിങ്ങോട്ട് തന്നാലും മതി, എനിക്കുള്ളത് കാണാതിരിക്കില്ല.
ഇല്ല വാസുമാമ, ഇത് ഞമ്മള് തരില്ല.
എനിക്ക് വാടക നാളെ കിട്ടിയിരിക്കണം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ രണ്ടെണ്ണവും വീട് കാലിയാക്കിയേക്കണം.
പലിശക്കാരൻ മമ്മദ് ഇങ്ങോട്ടാണല്ലോ പറഞ്ഞത്. എവിടാ ഇപ്പൊ നൊളിക്കണേ? ഇത് പടച്ചോനെ, പെരയും പൂട്ടി അകത്തിരിക്കണതാ നല്ലത്, വെട്ടൊന്ന് തുണ്ടൻ രണ്ടാവോന്.
ഇവിടെ ആരെയും കണ്ടില്ലല്ലോ, എവിടെ പോയി? എന്റെ നിഴൽ വട്ടം കണ്ടപ്പോ പെരയും നിറങ്ങി ഓടിയ, ഇവിടെ കേട്ടു രണ്ടിനെ എന്റെ കയ്യിൽ കിട്ടും.
എന്റെ പൊന്നുമോനെ, ഇജാ കുടുക്കയിലുള്ള കായ് പലിശക്കാരൻ മമ്മദിന്റെ കടം വീട്ടാനെങ്കിലും താടാ.
ഉമ്മാ, എന്റെ നീല കളറുള്ള സൈക്കിള്.
പടച്ചോനെ, ഇതെന്താ ഇപ്പൊ ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു മഴ? ഇന്നലെ മുതല് തുടങ്ങിയതാണല്ലോ, ഒരു തുള്ളി തോന്നിട്ടില്ല. നമ്മൾ എങ്ങനെയാ പണിക്ക് പോണേ? എന്താ ഒരു കാറ്റ്! എന്റെ ചെറുക്കനെ കാണണില്ലല്ലോ, കറണ്ടും പോയല്ലോ. ആരിഫേ, എന്താ മോനെ ഇത്രയും വൈകിയേ?
പുഴയുടെ അക്കരയുള്ള വീടുകളെല്ലാം മലവെള്ളത്തിൽ ഒലിച്ചു പോയിമ്മ. ഡാമം തുറന്നു വിട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു, കൊറേ പേരെ കാണാനില്ലെന്നും പറയണ്. ആകെയുള്ള പാലവും ഒലിച്ചു പോയി. എന്റെ കൂട്ടരുടെ വീടെല്ലാം നശിച്ചു. എല്ലാരും സ്കൂളിലേക്ക് മാറ്റിയിരിക്കണം.
അയ്യോ സാഹിറ, എന്റെ വീട്! ഇനി ഞാൻ എന്ത് ചെയ്യാന്? എന്റെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾക്ക് കയറി കിടക്കാൻ ഒരിടയില്ലാണ്ടായല്ലോ. എന്റെ ഈശ്വര!
അമ്മേ, കരയല്ലേ അമ്മേ?
നിങ്ങള് വിഷമിക്കേണ്ടിരിക്കേ ദേവകിയെ, വെള്ളമിറങ്ങണവരെ ഈടെ നിന്നോളി, നമുക്ക് സന്തോഷേ ഉള്ളൂ. ആരിഫേ, സ്കൂളിൽ പോവാറായില്ലേ?
ഇതാ പോവായി ഉമ്മ.
ഇതിപ്പോ നീ എങ്ങട്ടാ എന്റെ ആരിഫയെ കൊണ്ടോണേ?
സ്കൂളിലെ ദുരിതാശ്വാസ നിധിയിലെ നമ്മുടെ കുടുക്കയിലുള്ള കായ് മുഴുവനും കൊടുക്കാണുമ്മ.
അപ്പോ നിന്റെ നീല കളറുള്ള സൈക്കിള്?
എന്റെ നാടും നാട്ടാരും എല്ലാം നഷ്ടപ്പെട്ട് സ്കൂളിൽ കഴിയുമ്പം ഞമ്മക്ക് സൈക്കിള് വേണ്ടുമ്മ. എന്റെ ചങ്ങായിമാര് വീടും പുസ്തകവും ഇല്ലാതെ കരയുമ്പോ ഞമ്മള് പുതിയ സൈക്കിള് വാങ്ങിയ പടച്ചോ പൊറുക്കൂലുമ.
ഉമ്മാന്റെ മോൻ പറഞ്ഞതാ ശരി, വാടക വീടാണേലും അത് പൊളിയാണ്ട് പടച്ചോ ഞമ്മളെ കാത്തില്ലേ? ഇല്ലാത്തവർക്ക് കൊടുക്കുമ്പോളാ ഞമ്മള് മനസ്സന്മാരാകണത്.
ഹലോ, ആരിഫിന്റെ വീടല്ലേ?
ഞമ്മളാ ആരിഫ്.
ആ, ഞാൻ ഗരുഡ് സൈക്കിൾ കമ്പനിയുടെ മാനേജിംഗ് ഡയറക്ടറാണ്. ഇത് ഈ പ്രദേശത്തെ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂട്ടർ, എന്റെ സുഹൃത്താണ്. ആരിഫ് സൈക്കിളിനായി കരുതി വെച്ച പണം പ്രളയ ദുരിതാശ്വാസ നിധിയിലേക്ക് സംഭാവന ചെയ്ത വിവരം സ്കൂൾ ഹെച്ച്എം ഞങ്ങളെ അറിയിച്ചു.
മോന്റെ നല്ല മനസ്സാണ് ഞങ്ങൾ ഇവിടെ വരാൻ കാരണം. മോന് ഒരു ചെറിയ സമ്മാനം, ഞങ്ങളുടെ കമ്പനി വക ഒരു സൈക്കിൾ.
സന്തോഷായി.
എന്ത് നല്ല കുട്ടിയാ ആരിഫ്.
അതെ അതെ, മനുഷ്യത്വം നഷ്ടപ്പെടാത്ത ഒരു പുതിയ തലമുറ നമുക്ക് ചുറ്റുമുണ്ടെന്ന് ഈ വാർത്തയിലൂടെ മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ സാധിക്കും. ഇല്ലേ അരുണിമ?
ശരിയാ, പ്രളയമേഖലയിലേക്ക് പാഞ്ഞെത്തിയ കടലിന്റെ മക്കളെ പോലെ.
നമ്മുടെ സ്കൂൾ മാനേജ്മെന്റും ദുരിതാശ്വാസ നിധിയിലേക്ക് പണമായും സാധനമായും ഒക്കെ ധാരാളം സംഭാവനകൾ ചെയ്തല്ലോ. അതും എടുത്തു പറയേണ്ട കാര്യം തന്നെയാണ്.
അതും നമ്മളെ പോലുള്ള കുട്ടികൾ തന്നെയാണ് അല്ലേ വാണി? അയ്യോ, ബെല്ലടിക്കാൻ സമയമായി. ഫസ്റ്റ് പീരീഡ് മാത്സാ, വേഗം വാ.
ജീവിതയാത്രയിൽ എല്ലാം നഷ്ടപ്പെട്ട് ആത്മഹത്യയിലേക്കും തീരാ ദുഃഖത്തിലേക്കും അടിപതര വീണു പോകുന്ന ഓരോ മനുഷ്യർക്കും താങ്ങായി തണലായി ഇനിയും ധാരാളം ആരിഫുമാർ നമുക്ക് ചുറ്റും ഉണ്ടാകട്ടെ. ഈ ലഘുനാടകത്തിലെ കഥാപാത്രങ്ങൾ: സാഹിറ ആർദ്ര എസ് അനിൽ, ആരിഫ് അഭിനവ് വി സി, വാസു ഫെബിൻ എയർ, പലിശക്കാരൻ മമ്മദ്, മുഹമ്മദ് അഷ്ഫഖ്, ഗരുഡ് സൈക്കിൾ കമ്പനി മാനേജിംഗ് ഡയറക്ടർ നവീൻ ജയാർ, ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂട്ടർ ആരോമൽ, അയൽക്കാരി ശ്രീലക്ഷ്മി, മകൻ റോഷൻ, മകൾ ഷിമുന, സ്കൂൾ വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾ വാണി ആൻഡ് അരുണിമ. കഥ തിരക്കഥ സംഭാഷണം കുമാരി ഷീബ ആൻഡ് ഷീജ സീജി.
The play was an eye-opening one.
Yes, dear, it was.
I request the audience to give them a big applause.
Now, we have the Rainbow Fairies dance.
A spectacular performance of our first standard students.
Exactly. I just like the colors of the rainbow. It's an arc of spectral colors.
Yes, Rainbow Fairies are ready now.
Enjoy the colorful dance.
Rocking students of Standard 2, use possible properties to delight us with their charming performance.
Dear audience, watch, enjoy and relax this razzle-dazzle performance.
Thank you.
To success. It's a result of preparation, hard work, and perseverance. Now, it's time to give away the prizes. Let me invite our dear Vice Principal, Reverend Sister Sophie Joseph, to give away the prizes for general proficiency to our little ones. From Standard 1st, Ritika B. Nair. Standard 2nd, Terin R.P. Aisha S.A. Standard 3. Angel L.C. Standard 4. Thank you, sister. Now, I call upon Mrs. Sheeta Nair and Mrs. Sarada to the stage.
Good evening all. Thank you, Mrs. Bindu. Your enthusiasm will inspire others to move forward with more plans and actions that bring rewarding achievements. It's time now to felicitate the academic excellences for the academic year 2019-20 for classes 5 to 10. It's a privilege and honor to have the parish priest of Immaculate Conception Cathedral, Reverend Monsignor Alphonse Ligori, for the proficiency prize distribution. May I now request Reverend Monsignor Alphonse Ligori to hand over the proficiency prizes and acknowledge the achievements of our brilliant students. Let's give a big round of applause. Standard 5. Dear P. Charles, I request the audience to encourage our dear students with a big round of applause. Standard 6, Akash R. Standard 7, Anina P. R. Standard 8, Aditya J. L. Please give a big round of applause for our dear students. Standard 9, Kaveri Nair. Standard 10, Anne John. Thank you, Father. Hearty congrats to the prize winners. I'm sure it's a tremendous boost for them and it will help them to strive and excel and aim higher for even bigger accomplishments in life. May I now request our Vice Principal, Reverend Sister Sophie Joseph, to acknowledge Reverend Monsignor Alphonse Ligori with a token of gratitude. Thank
Thank you, sister, and thank you, father, once again. Now I request Miss Meenu and Miss Carolyn to come on to the stage.
Thank you, Shija Naya, teacher. Good evening, one and all. BCT, Believers Communicative English Training Institute, teaches communicative English in our school, and they conduct various activities and competitions to enhance the students' skill in English. Students have been selected based on their performance in BCT's activities. I invite our PTA President, Mr. Gobaguma, to hand over the trophies for the winners. Sir, please. BCT Best Performance Award for BCT's Answerers Activity in High School Section, Krishna L. Prakash of Standard 9. In UP Section, Parvati S. of Standard 7. For the language skill, BCT Language Queen Award goes to Anjana PR of 9th Standard. BCT Language Princess Award goes to Asha Michelle John of Standard 5th. BCT Language Little Prince Award goes to Terin RP of Standard 2. Congratulations for all the winners. Thank you, sir. I hand over the mic to Ms. Mima Mercy and Hemima Mercy. Thank you.
Thank you, Meenu ma'am. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. An award is not only a great prestige or a mark of excellence, but is also a tremendous boost for someone to strive and excel higher and aim for even bigger accomplishments in life. It is my pleasure to share with all of you here the joy and achievements of our outstanding students of our school. Now it's time to honor the winners of Let's Pronounce Correctly competition, which was conducted for the classes 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 by Believers Communicative English Training Institution. To give away the prizes to the winners, I humbly invite our PTA Vice President, Reverend Mr. Mohan Raj on the dais. Please, sir. Class 5, the winner is Malavika G.S. Class 6, Akshay V.V. Please give them a big round of applause. For class 8, it's Maithili Suresh. Class 9, it's Niman Jyoti Mariam. Congratulations to all the winners, and thank you so much, sir, for giving away the prizes. And now, we are proud to announce that our students Naufa Nashad from 5th standard and Niha Nausad from 2nd standard have secured first place in 5th National Championship Karate Championship 2020, which held at Bangalore. To give away the prize, I request our LP Section Principal Sister, Reverend Sister Mary Bergman, on the stage. Please, sister. Now I invite Naushad sister on the stage. Naufa Nashad from 5th standard. Please put your hands together for the winners. Niha Naushad from 2nd standard. For BCT's Let's Pronounce Correctly winner, for class 7 it's Lakshmi Krishna A. Congratulations to all the winners. Thank you so much, sister, for giving away the prizes. Thank you. It's over to Mrs. Shija.
Thank you, Mercy. The man who moves a mountain begins by carrying away small stones. The next prize we are going to give is to the teachers with full attendance and to the toppers of moral science and catechism for their punctuality, dedication and hard work. Let me call upon our dear manager, Reverend Sister Mary Brace, to hand over the prizes. Sister, please. Teachers with full attendance. Mrs. Sumi Eshvi. Mrs. Sujata D.K. Mrs. Divya R.C. Ajita Kumari. Moral Science topper of this academic year goes to Sneha S. of Standard 10. The Christian Doctrine topper of the academic year 2019-20 goes to Bibina Fernandez of Standard 10. The KCSL star of the year 2019-20 is Annie B.R. of Standard 9. May I now invite our principal, Reverend Sister Flory Padua, to the stage and acknowledge our dear manager, Reverend Sister Mary Grace, with a token of gratitude. Thank you, sisters, and congratulations to the winners. I hand over to Mrs. Ashley and Mrs. Tushara.
Thank you, Mrs. Shija and Mrs. Anita. Now, I am very happy to stand before you to honor our higher secondary students who secured full A+ in last year higher secondary board examination conducted in March 2019. For that, let me please invite our sister in charge, Reverend Sister Mary Larina, onto the stage. Please, sister. Ardra, yes. Nivedita B.S. Arya P.S. Samira S.R. Havya B.A. Helena L. Heron. Thank you, sister. Congratulations to all the prize winners. May I now hand over the mic to Mrs. Asha Ivy and Mrs. Sangeeta.
Thank you, Ashley and Tushara. Good evening. This is a much awaiting moment in a student's life, as it gives the returns to the effort in curricular, co-curricular and extracurricular activities put in throughout the academic year. May I request our beloved principal, Reverend Sister Flory Padua, to give away the prizes. Please, sister. We have Jenika B. Sarasam of 9A, the top scorer. She bagged 8 individual first prizes: English, Malayalam and essay elocution, English and Malayalam essay writing, English and Malayalam story writing, and Malayalam poem writing. Dear audience, put your hands together for Jenika. Next is the topper from UP section, Sania SS. Benson B. Now I announce the toppers of LP section, Asmi SN. Kevin A.D. We have H. another prize to be given to Jenika B. Sarasam, who represented our school, the sub-district, the district, to the par in the state level exhibition and Kalolsavam 2019-20. I invite Jenika B. Sarasam in the disguise of Shylock onto the stage. Dear all, put your hands together for the toppers. Congratulations to all the winners. Thank you, sister. Now I hand over to our beloved principal, Reverend Sister Flory Padua, and I also invite Mrs. Hazel and Mrs. Mercy Rani.
Now I request our chief guest, Reverend Sister Mary Elma, the Provincial Superior, Southern Province, to be on stage. Put your hands together. She will give away the special prizes
of the school. The best outgoing student of Standard 10. Shreya S. Anand of 10th B. She is excellent in academics, takes part in cultural activities, studious, sincere and industrious. The best outgoing student of Standard 7, Altaf Ahmed of 7th A. He is competitive, studious, talented and participates in all the activities. The best class for the year 2019-20, the criteria, the best behavior, the best efforts and most disciplined students of our school is Standard 8th D. The class teacher, Ms. Hazel Leo, and the captain to be on stage. The best house for the year 2019-20 is Sapphire. They secured 638 points. Put your hands together. While the Ruby House secured 542 points. Congratulations to all the prize winners. Parents, please give them a loud applause. Thank you, sister. This is Ruby House. I invite our manager, Reverend Sister Mary Grace, to come forward to render gratitude for our chief guest, Reverend Sister Mary Ilma, with a memento. I would request the most honorable personality tonight, our chief guest, Reverend Sister Mary Ilma, to give her valuable message.
Most Reverend Monsignor Alphonse Ligori, parish priest of the cathedral, manager Sister Mary Grace, principal Sister Florrie, all the dear sisters, PTA president Mr. Gopakumar, vice president Reverend Mohindas Mohan Raj, and all the staff, students, parents, well-wishers, benefactors, a very pleasant evening. We have been enjoying the pleasant evening so far, and you have some more very spectacular, gorgeous items, so I will not take much time. Today is a very special day for the parents, students, teachers, and all those who are connected with this school, especially for parents, since it is your day, whether it is called Parents' Day or Annual Day, it is the day when parents get the opportunity to witness the talents of your children showcased on the stage. You have already seen the talents, and still there is. These are moments of joy and pride for you and for all of us. St. Teresa's Girls Higher Secondary School has the look of any reputed international school, with its colorful ambience, fine infrastructures and efficient management, staff and students. Just as Rome was built not on in a day. This institution too took many years, nearly a century. Within a few years, we'll be celebrating the centenary of this institution. It was the work, hard work, dedicated service, and many sacrifices made by the pioneers and to all those who are still working, the present management staff. My hearty congratulations to all of them. St. Therese's Convent School was and is still a star illuminating and guiding thousands of students year after year for a brighter future. Those who have gone out of the portals of this institution shine like little stars in different parts of our country and elsewhere. Knowledge is always compared to light. Knowledge dispels darkness of ignorance, poverty, diseases, and all negative attitudes from one's mind and heart. Children are God's precious gifts to you. Life is precious and beautiful, and you have the responsibility to bring them up according to God's will and plan. Our world is changing very fast, and values too are being misinterpreted by many. Very often, parents are controlled by children instead of children being controlled by parents. Parents are the first teachers, and home is their first school where they learn the ABC of life. Teach them the preciousness of life. Teach them the life is more precious than anything you can buy with money. More precious than examinations, top ranks, failures, successes, approval, appreciation, power, positions, and possessions. All these things will pass away one day, but life is eternal. We have come from God, and we are meant to go back to God. On the one hand, people are doing everything they can to save a life, especially those of their dear ones. And they are ready to cross continents and oceans to go to America or England to take someone dear who is very seriously ill, to prolong their life, to save their life. And on the other hand, there are so many young ones as well as even older ones who take away their lives even for a very insignificant reason, silly reasons. Life is God's gift, and God alone has the right to take away life. Whatever God does, He does it for our good, though we may not understand it now. Life is precious and beautiful to be cherished and nourished. Today, parents are afraid to correct their children when they do something wrong because of possible disastrous reactions. Discipline at home is very poor in many cases, and the consequences are drastic too. The Bible is always more reliable for any issue in life. Here are a few of the verses about disciplining children. In the book of Proverbs, we read, "Whoever spares the rod hates his son or daughter, but he who loves him is diligent to discipline him." I hope you understood. Then in the letter to the Hebrews, "For the moment, all discipline seems painful rather than pleasant, but later it yields the peaceful fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it. Train up a child in the way which he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord." So in all these verses of the Bible, the scripture exhorts us to discipline children on time. Disciplining children is not punishing them, but it is correcting them, and it will help them in their life, and you are doing a good thing for them. That is the expression of your love. When you don't want to correct, when you don't want to discipline, it shows that you really don't love your children. Discipline prevents destruction. So the message is very clear. Disciplined lives reap rewards. I'll just end my speech with a little story. A man was traveling through the desert, hungry, thirsty, and tired, when he came upon a tree bearing juicy, sweet fruits and affording plenty of shade, underneath which ran a spring of water. He ate of the fruit and drank of the water and rested beneath the shade. When he was about to leave, he turned to the tree and said, "Tree, O tree, with what should I bless you? Should I bless you that your fruit be sweet? Your fruit is already sweet. Should I bless you that your shade be plentiful? Your shade is plentiful. That a spring of water should run beneath you? A spring of water runs beneath you. There is one thing with which I can bless you. May it be God's will that all the tree planted from your seeds should be like you." So this is a piece of counsel for you, that what you receive from this institution may bear fruit, and that you too be like this life-giving fruit or benevolent fruit, a tree. May all our students, staff, parents, benefactors, friends, and well-wishers be messengers of love, peace, harmony, generosity, kindness, goodness. May this institution continue to be a guiding star to illumine the path of many towards the goal of life. God bless you all.
Thank you so much, dear sister, for devoting your precious time and enjoying with all
with your words of wisdom and experience. Thank you, sister.
Music has no boundaries, says William Shakespeare. If music be the foot of love, play on.
Certainly music is a moral law too. It gives soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and charm and gaiety to life and to everything.
Our third standard students with cowboy song precisely. Let us listen and enjoy the Latin American lyrics.
A spellbound performance.
Six standard students are ready to perform captivating, eye-catching Marathi dance. Today, we are here to witness some great talents performing a beautiful dance. Marathi dance.
பிங்காக போரி பிங்காக போரி பிங்காக போரி பிங்கா மல பிஞ்ஞானி மால போல விழி ராத்த காலவெளி போரி பிங்கா
பிங்காக போரி பிங்காக போரி பிங்கா பிங்காக போரி பிங்கா
is an amazing portrayal. On the stage, now we have a variety dance.
Yes, we shall have a variety property dance.
The rocking students of Standard 4 use sticks to delight us with their charming performance.
My dear audience, watch, enjoy, and relax this enchanting performance.
Next, we have a Punjabi dance of our 5th standard students.
Sometimes life confusion tends to arise and only dialogue of dance seems to make sense.
If spirit is the seed, dance is the water of its evolution. Bhangra dance, a rocking reed.
Watch and enjoy!
सारे शौक पुगा दांगे तेरे गुट नु करा सरदारिए
Oh, ஜண்டியேறி தேடி பிள்ளையாக்கி ਵਾਲੀ ਲਈ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਤੇ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਦੀ ਬਣੀ ਗੱਲ ਤਾਂ ਬਿਨਾਂ ਕੋਈ ਕਾਰੇ
Guys, rocked.
Now, we shall watch and enjoy a marvelous performance by our fourth standard students.
Wow, rain dance. It's a cry of delight and an excellent entertainment.
Let's watch and get wet in the rain of fabulous dance.
बन जाए ना कोई कहानी देखो देखो है शाम बड़ी दीवानी धीरे धीरे बन जाए ना कोई कहानी दिल पर है दिलकश है दिलदार नजारे हैं आज जमीन पर उतरे कितने सितारे हैं अगलो होश नमी दानम हम है दिल है और जानम बस दीवानगी 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 है ना कोई रहसन ना रहबर ये इल्जाम लगे किस पर बस दीवानगी 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 है All the hot girls put your hands up and say
dance. The next program is an English skit.
സാഹിത്യത്തിലെ മഹാനായ എഴുത്തുകാരനും കവിയും നാടകകൃത്തുമായ അതുല്യ പ്രതിഭയാണ് സർ വില്യം ഷേക്സ്പിയർ. 16th century രചിക്കപ്പെട്ട അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ ശ്രേഷ്ഠമായ നാടകമാണ് ദ മർച്ചന്റ് ഓഫ് വെനീസ്. ഒഴുകുന്ന പട്ടണം എന്നറിയപ്പെടുന്ന വെനീസിലെ ധനികനും മാന്യനുമായ കച്ചവടക്കാരനായിരുന്നു അന്റോണിയോ. പണം കടം കൊടുക്കുകയും ആവശ്യക്കാരെ സഹായിക്കുകയും ചെയ്തിരുന്ന അന്റോണിയോയുടെ ഉച്ച സുഹൃത്തായിരുന്നു ബസാനിയോ. സുന്ദരനും ആഡംബരപ്രിയനുമായിരുന്ന ബസാനിയോയുടെ ഏത് ആവശ്യത്തിനും ധനം നൽകിയിരുന്നത് അന്റോണിയോ ആയിരുന്നു. സുന്ദരിയും ധനികയുമായ പോർഷ്യോ ആയിരുന്നു ബസാനിയോയുടെ കാമുകി. പോർഷ്യയെ കണ്ട് വിവാഹ അഭ്യർത്ഥന നടത്തുന്നതിനായി ബസാനിയോയ്ക്ക് ബെൽമണ്ടിലേക്ക് പോകണമായിരുന്നു. അതിനാവശ്യമായ പണത്തിന് വേണ്ടി ബസാനിയോ അന്റോണിയോയെ സമീപിക്കുമെങ്കിലും കച്ചവട കപ്പലുകളിൽ പണമെല്ലാം നിക്ഷേപിച്ചിരുന്നതിനാൽ അന്റോണിയോ നിസ്സഹായനായിരുന്നു. അതിനാൽ അവർ ഷൈലോക്ക് എന്ന ക്രൂരനും കൊള്ളപ്പലിശക്കാരനുമായ യഹൂദനെ സമീപിക്കുന്നു. അന്റോണിയോയോട് പൂർവ്വ വൈരാഗ്യമുള്ള ഷൈലോക്ക് 3000 ഡക്കറ്റ്സ് കടം നൽകുന്നതിനോടൊപ്പം അന്റോണിയോയെ ഒരു കരാറിൽ ഒപ്പുവയ്പ്പിച്ചു. കൃത്യസമയത്ത് പണം തിരിച്ചടയ്ക്കാൻ അന്റോണിയോയ്ക്ക് കഴിയാതെ വന്നാൽ അയാളുടെ ശരീരത്തിൽ നിന്നുള്ള 1 പൗണ്ട് മാംസം ക്രൂരനായ ഷൈലോക്കിന് അവകാശപ്പെട്ടതായിരിക്കും. നിർഭാഗ്യവശാൽ കൃത്യസമയത്ത് പണം തിരിച്ചടയ്ക്കാൻ അന്റോണിയോയ്ക്ക് കഴിയാതെ വന്നു. മഹാക്രൂരനും നീചനുമായ ഷൈലോക്ക് കരാറിലെ ശിക്ഷ നടപ്പാക്കുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടി കോടതിയെ സമീപിക്കുന്നു. തുലാസിന്റെ തട്ടിൽ നീതിക്കും ന്യായത്തിനുമാണോ അതോ കരുണ എന്ന ദൈവീക ഭാവത്തിനാണോ തൂക്കം കൂടുതലെന്ന് നമുക്ക് അന്വേഷിക്കാം. ഞങ്ങളിത് ആരംഭിക്കുന്നു, ദി മെർച്ചന്റ് ഓഫ് വെനീസ്.
Mercy or justice, which is greater? This skit that our HS students are about to perform on stage now tells the world that the divine quality of mercy is always greater than justice. Let's watch the skit from the extract of the drama The Merchant of Venice by the famous writer William Shakespeare. The Merchant of Venice.
Venice, there lives a rich merchant named Antonio. He is very honest and kind-hearted. He used to lend money to people without taking any interest. So he is loved by all. Antonio has a bosom friend, Bassanio. They are very close and they live as if they have one heart and one purse between them. In the same town, there lives a greedy Jewish moneylender named Shylock. Because after lending money, he takes very high interest from the people. Bassanio has a wealthy lady love named Portia. He needs money to buy some gifts for her and propose her. For that, he approaches Antonio.
Antonio, I have a great news. I have fallen in love with a girl. Her name is Portia. She is rich too.
That's wonderful news, Bassanio.
I want to buy some gift for her and propose her. The only problem is that I don't have money right now. I know I owe you a lot of money, but can I borrow a little more? I promise I'll give you back.
Bassanio, you know that my money is yours, but I don't have money right now. I have spent all my money on my ships.
What should I do now?
We can borrow money from the moneylender named Shylock.
Shylock?
Oh yes, we have no other way. He always has money with him. He will certainly lend us money. We can pay him high interest.
Thank you, Antonio. You are really a great friend. Welcome, Antonio. Welcome.
I need your help. I need 3,000 ducats.
Antonio needs the help of this poor Shylock. You have always insulted me and now you are asking me money?
Don't lend money as if to your friend, but rather as an enemy, so that if I fail to repay, you may take high penalty.
I will help you. I don't even charge you a single ducat of interest. However, the sum 3,000 ducats is a large amount. What will happen if you don't pay the money?
Don't worry, Shylock. I'll pay you back.
I know that. But for a fun, I want you to sign a bond.
Bond?
Yes. If you don't repay the money, I need a pound of flesh from any part of your body.
Okay, I'm ready to sign the bond.
No, Antonio, you should not do that.
Don't worry, Bassanio, I can repay on time.
Before his death, Portia's father had arranged 3 caskets to save his daughter from the fortune hunters: gold, silver, and lead. One who chooses the right casket can marry Portia. Now it's your turn, Bassanio. Make your choice.
Outside are often ugly inside, so I'll choose the leaden casket.
Bassanio opens the casket. Find Portia's picture inside it. I'm very happy, Lord Bassanio. From today onwards, my wealth, my mansion, everything is yours. I give everything to you with this ring. Please do not part with it or lose it. Come, dear, let's celebrate.
Past and silhouettes upon the wall.
Bassanio receives a letter from Antonio.
Sweet Bassanio, my ships are all lost. My bond to the Jew is forfeited. In paying it, I shall lose my life. I wish to see you at my death, but it's your pleasure.
You are my husband right now. Go to your friend and pay thrice of the original amount and tear off the bond.
Be merciful, Shylock. How can you hope mercy from God if you yourself show no mercy to your fellow beings?
I need justice. I need my penalty.
A clever young lawyer has come from another town to plead for Antonio. He is Balthasar.
You may proceed.
Thank you, my lord. Be merciful, Shylock.
Why should I be merciful?
Mercy is twice blessed. It blesses him that gives and him that receives. Great kings have always shown mercy. It's an attribute of God himself. So take this sum, twice of 40 you, and let me tear off the bond.
I'm willing to pay 10 times the sum that Antonio owes to you. I want justice, not mercy, and the fulfillment of my contract. Read the contract. It says that a pound of flesh from the place near to Antonio's heart is mine. I don't want money. I want a pound of flesh. Do you agree to the terms and conditions in the bond, Antonio?
Yes, I do.
Do you have anything to say before you die?
No, I don't. Goodbye, my dear friend. Don't blame yourself for my death.
Oh, Antonio. You're the best friend in the world. Enough of this. Let's get on with it. I need my pound of flesh. Is there a scale to weigh the flesh? I have it ready. Have you arranged a physician to take care of Antonio if he bleeds to death? The bond says nothing about a physician. A pound of flesh is yours. Law allows it and the court awards it. You're a clever lawyer. You understand justice. Wait! Wait a minute. This bond doesn't give you a drop of blood. The words expressly specify a pound of flesh, not a single drop of blood. If Antonio loses a drop of blood, you will break the law. Do you understand, Shylock? If that's the case, let me have the money. No, not so fast. You have already refused the money. You shall have justice and nothing else. You're a Jew. According to the laws of Venice, anyone who is not himself a citizen of Venice tries to take a life of a citizen, he must be put to death. And his money and property must be equally shared by the state and the man he had tried to kill. Shylock, your life lies at the mercy of the Jew. Therefore, down on your knees and ask him to pardon you.
You may see the difference of our belief in God. I pardon you your life before you ask it. But you must give half of your wealth to Antonio and the other half to the city of Venice.
What could a moneylender do? If all the money is taken from him, take my life as well.
What mercy can you offer him, Antonio?
Let him keep my share and be merciful to others in future.
Go, Shylock, and be merciful.
Antonio, you should pay this clever young lawyer a handsome reward. The court is adjourned.
Most worthy gentlemen, I and my friend Antonio have been saved by your wisdom. Now, I beg you to accept 3,000 ducats.
No, I don't want money. I want your ring. I'll wear it for your sake.
No, no, I can't give you this. This is my wedding ring.
Dear Bassanio, let him have the ring. Let my love and the great service he had done for me be valued against your wife's displeasure.
Okay then, I'll give you. Thank you, gentlemen.
At Belmont.
Happy to see you back.
Meet my friend Antonio.
Bassanio, where is the ring?
I had given it to the lawyer who saved Antonio's life.
No, you are lying.
My sweet lady, pardon me.
You are to blame for giving away my first gift for you. I swear I shall never speak to you until I see the ring.
It is my misfortune to have been the cause of this quarrel. I swear Bassanio will never again break a promise to you.
Then give him the ring and tell him to take better care of it than he did before.
Promise me, Bassanio, that you will keep this ring always with you.
Oh God, this is the very same ring which I gave to the lawyer in Venice.
Are you all amazed?
Were you actually the lawyer? I couldn't recognize you. Oh sweet Portia, you are the clever woman in Italy. You have saved my best friend's life.
Antonio, I have a better news for you than you expect. 3 of your ships have come back and your money is safe.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.